This is the full build of the Master Grade Super Deformed Freedom Gundam. Okay, I've got all the pieces prepped, cleaned, and everything else, so we're ready for the build. So I'm just going to go right ahead and start this. I'm really looking forward to this build. I'd like to say this is the first time I've built something like this, but of course it has to be because it's the first MGSD kit ever created. But just taking the pieces off the runners made me very excited about putting this thing together. And there are just a ton of pieces on here. Even the real grades I've put together haven't had this many pieces. I think it's mostly because the Freedom Gundam is a very complex mobile suit, but I think they really went out of their way to make sure that this met the Master Grade label. And there's a lot of color separation through the pieces, and the detail is amazing. So, and I mean, there's absolutely no color correcting stickers on this, where sometimes even on a Master Grade, you might have color correcting stickers at times, especially the older ones. So I just can't wait to see what this looks like. I'm assuming it's going to look just like this, or at least as close to this as it could possibly be. But I'm really excited about this. So let's just get in there. I mean, talking about the number of pieces, this is for these pieces here. Are just for the head. I've never encountered this many pieces for just the head of a model. I don't think I've even seen half this many pieces just for the head at this point in time. I haven't done a true, you know, one hundredth master grade yet, but this is just insane. But anyway, I digress. I mean, when I say there's no color correcting stickers, even the eyes are not color corrected. There are clear pieces. These little tiny plastic, yellow plastic pieces that are the eyes. And then the other details are taken care of by this silver piece here. I mean, it's just, let me just show. Look at that detail on that eye. Just, I mean, that's just amazing to me. So, okay. So we've got okay. I guess that's just showing more detail as to how the piece goes in. Okay. Yeah, I kind of figured it out.
So maybe those are not supposed to go. Nope, they don't. Okay. As far as that goes in. That's pretty cool. Much better. Okay. Thank you. further in, it just sits there. Okay. This is the shroud. Wow.
Now that's a head. It's just absolutely amazing. Even on the front here, there is, I mean, when I did the panel lining, I noticed this, but it's got the insignia right there on the forehead piece, which is just great, just like the anime does. Okay. Oh, I see. That's different. Oh, okay. This is the shorter piece. Thank you.
using that sleeve. So that helps with the waist movement.
Okay. A little bit tricky to get that together, but this little tab right here, that little tab there that fits into this little piece right here in the top, in the front, and that can be a little bit tricky to get it perfectly lined up. This piece here goes this. Sits down into there.
Excellent. As this goes up here, that makes more sense.
Nice solid snaps on these things. No question that it got together.
Okay, yes, that is right. Okay. This with the tab up. Down. And this goes in. Thank you.
Okay, if it's tilt that way. These bones there. Oh, that's nice. Very solid. Okay, better remember that. If you push too far in the back, that will pop out. Okay. And then these two pieces. Draw the cows to the side. Clavicle pieces here. And this. Everything together, right? And then this goes on here. Slips right into there. Okay, so that means that this is not in the right place. Thank you. Our body. The head goes right on without any problem. Look at that. That's some good movement. Okay. Now for the arms, they're pretty much the same, except for just how the shoulders are oriented, but all the pieces are the same. There's no, you don't have to worry about left, except, I'm sorry, except for the hand. The hand does have right and left pieces just because of the way the fingers and thumbs are snapped together. But the rest of it are all the same pieces. It just depends on how you orient the shoulders when you put everything together. The legs. Sorry about that. I wonder if I couldn't find the hand. Grab the wrong pieces. We want arms.
Hello.
Just looking for the second of that piece. I know it's somewhere in here. I remember cleaning them. Let's do this real quick. So let's see here. We've got this right here. This goes in here. Oops. This goes in here.
Thank you.
Okay. More pieces that get fit into here. So that thing in the back, oops. Little gears here that have the mesh. There we go. I'm assuming that lifting that moves the thruster. Okay, then we just okay, this is a tough one to get together, huh? This. Oh, this is the shoulder, of course. Oh, that's cool. That is very cool. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. A bunch of little pieces here now. That's that. So this is here. That right there. This piece. This. This. Goes like that. Okay. This piece goes in back here. Okay. And then thank you.
that's cool. We figured out how to do this type of hand without the fingers falling off, it seems. That's nice to see. Do the other arm. Thank you.
No, it's got to be the other way. That's the pinky.
Sure, the back of the hand isn't one of these. Okay, it's right here. Okay, I really like the fact that they figured out how to do these jointed hands. If anyone's worked with the real grade ones, they're terrible. Now, I don't know that this would work with the real grade ones or not, but who knows? Maybe they'll decide to try it. That's cool. It's just a simple thing like putting the backing of the hand in such a way that it keeps the ball joints in place
Okay. So. This would go in here. And then. Backwards. I put the other one backwards also. Yes, I did. Okay. The way the arms go on is you put them on a certain way and then you turn them and, they lock into place. There's a little tab that locks them into place. The only reason that would work is if this piece here is facing the right way. And that is when you put this in here, there's this little narrow channel there at the bottom of the piece right there, and that has to be pointing down towards the peg here, or it won't, the locking mechanism won't work the way it's supposed to. And I happen to get that wrong on both of them. What are the odds? Yeah, it does highlight it there, and the instruction is miss it. You know, the orientation of the piece. Now what happens? Is that there's this little key bit right there. So you start the hand up here, you put it on, you slide it in, then you turn it, and that holds everything together. One shoulder, nice and secure. then. There we go. We've got shoulders and arms on. Okay, cool. Oh, I guess it's easier if you put the shoulders upside down. I guess that makes sense. Turn them all at the same time, but I still did it. Okay, now it's time for legs. And with the legs are also, both of them are exactly the same. All the same pieces, nothing special. The only difference is the ball joint, which is all snapped together the exact same way, but just whether or not you turn it one way or the other. That's it. So, you don't have to worry about whether you got the pieces correct. It's just how the, well, this piece right here, essentially, eventually is oriented when everything's put together. Okay. Piece looks quite a bit different when it's at a side 2D than it is 3D. I always figured this was part of the foot. It might actually still be part of the foot. Oh yes, it is. Okay. Okay, so that locks that in place. That's cool. Okay. I have it upside down. This puts on nice. It's kind of like a... Okay. This right here. There's the foot. Assume there's other stuff that goes on that eventually. Up this way. That. We have this and this. Thank you.
is supposed to go in there.
Okay, gotta be very precise about how this goes together. There's lots of little tiny grooves they have to fit into. Okay. Let me take this. This will come in. Make this one. Oh, there we go. Okay, it does push down once you get in the right place. And then this fits in nicely here. There we go. We'll close off the... Okay. And then... This? No, it doesn't make sense. That would snap in. I guess I bet you it's going to get held in by something else, other pieces here. Okay, these side pieces, it looks like. Okay. That's what that little lip is for. Okay. Not to be able to go, but we can. Not right. Okay. Maybe it is, but that just doesn't make sense. Mm. This is just kind of hanging out there. It's not clipping in anywhere. I guess there'll be other things that hold it in, but it just seems really... Okay. I guess it was right. There we go. That's what keeps that knee piece in. There we go. Okay. That's what keeps that in. Okay, that's pretty cool. And then I'm assuming this goes on the knee. We got those, and then there we go. Why do I have these extra pieces? Those are from the other leg, okay. And then okay, silver shows, okay. one leg. It'll be easier to put the second leg together since now I know how to recognize the pieces from the from the diagrams. Yeah, that's what happened. Those got into the wrong compartment. So, we got this and this. Then we have this. One thing I want to note about this piece is in the diagram, it's actually showing the inner part where it interlinks as if it's on the outside. So that's what was confusing about this the first time. You just want to keep that in mind, that sometimes what they're showing is inside parts. And I guess they kind of do the outline. It's inked, so I guess that means it's showing inside as opposed to outside. This right here and this together. This is in here. This and yes, this go together. This piece that connects everything here. So we have this that goes right now. This this will go the other way.
There we go.
Okay. This goes on to here. Excuse me. This goes right on up in there. And this. This goes on here and snaps in. Thank you. bring this down so we can put this in. And then this goes. And the foot goes on here. And we've got two lights. Okay, now on to the waist. The waist is pretty complex because there's a lot of fins and such for it. It's almost like a mini backpack just attached to the waist. But then again, there's nothing nothing compared to the backpack. The backpack is a ton of pieces. So, I mean, even the beam saber, I want this going. I'm going it back the wrong way. There we go. The beam saber handle even has two pieces. Set those aside. Okay. That's this. One more, so okay, so this goes in up here, so that's all the interconnecting, the legs, the back piece, you know, the back, I guess the waist pack, fanny pack, that's what we call it. And then this goes on. Thank you. Okay. This piece goes on here. That aside for a moment. We've got this. Should have one that's the opposite of that. There it is. I guess it's just, okay, not necessarily opposite, it's just upside down or not, the side here. I'm sorry, I guess that was the right way. Because I want the tab facing down. This little, there's a little tab on here that needs to face down. Okay. There's that. It's this. Okay. Be nice if they showed a little bit more than just the side view. I didn't realize what it was until I looked over here. Next step. There we go. Then it all made absolute sense. Okay. So the side skirts are a combination of It's a pain in the butt to get in there. But pushing this into here should seat everything properly. There we go. That's a pretty neat mechanism. I've never seen that used before. Sandwiching a ball joint between two other pieces. I'm quite impressed by that. These must be the front skirts then. Fit these in here. And then this must go on here. Still can hold those in. How this goes on without all this other stuff on there. Okay, and that just okay. That seeds in nicely. This one doesn't seem to want to. This is the same one that gave me some problems. Okay, definitely front skirts. Okay, and they say snap on the legs. There we go, nice little snap in. That's cool. Okay. this. This, push that on here. Cool. And there are two of these. So, nope. Where is the one that has... That's the... It has this little slot here. And then this. And then this. Okay, got those. And we get two of these, which is this right here, goes right to there. Okay, the black one goes on first. Then the red. Beautiful. Oh, I see that little... There you go. Let's get this other one together. Put it on upside down. Thank you. go. Okay. These little side guys. Those. Oh, I see. There are little gears there, aren't there? Close better. Thank you. Okay, very nice. That's the clip for the, oops. That's what holds this in. There we go. That's what flips those on. Okay. Very interesting side skirts. There's a tab. It then locks it into place. They've got a Bandai's got to do this with more models. These little tabs that lock pieces into place. Like side skirts and stuff like the skirts and the arms and stuff like that. And then we just put him on here. Not bad. That's cute. I like that. Okay. Now it's time for the backpack. These are all backpack pieces.
first. This. Let's see. Okay. That's neat.
This piece had, these round pieces that go in, these pegs have a tab. So you have to line up where it goes for this black ring piece, as well as internally, right there. Then you just twist it and it locks it in place. Okay. Okay, we're going to the fins now. This. Two of these. this. That's cool. Thank you. Okay, so that's those. Okay. Thank you.
Whoops.
Okay. Let's do this here. Thank you.
They should have given me instruction to put this piece on before everything else was connected. Unless I missed something. Oh. It shows it not connected, but it doesn't show this part before all this connecting everything. Oh, because it, it does. See. There we go. Let's pull this off. Come on. There we go. Okay. Okay, one half. Okay. There we go. Thank you.
plate number two.
Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, that's cool. Alrighty. And there we go. Okay, now we just do the weapons. Shield. Come on.
Look nice.
There we are, all together. That's pretty cool. I like the color separation on the weapon, which you don't get a lot of in many kits. So, I mean, just little tiny details like that make the gun just so much better. Cool. Well, that finishes this one, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you for the next one. Thank you for watching this video right to the end. If you did enjoy it, please do give it a thumbs up. That does help out the channel. If you would like notifications as to when new videos are posted to this channel, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you do have time, please do enjoy one of the videos that are popping up around my head.